So my iPad is literally like my best friend. I use this thing for everything.
She's an icon, she's a legend, and she is the moment. Now come on now.
What's up, icons? It's the iconic fashion figure back with a new video. And today I'm going to show you all the ways I use my iPad. Now my iPad is literally like my best friend, especially when it comes to my business. I mean, I use it for everything. Photo editing, video editing, organizing, planning. Everything is on this freaking iPad. I probably would be lost without it. And the funny thing is, years ago when iPads first came out, I had one, used it for a little while, and after a while, that thing just collected dust. Never would use it again. So when I bought a new iPad, I was kind of skeptical because I really wanted one, but then I just remembered the first time I bought one, I never used it. But I'm so glad I invested in this because this has been one of my best investments recently. So as stated, I pretty much use my iPad all for business. There's some personal on there, but mostly business. So I'm going to show you guys all the ways I use my iPad, starting with GoodNotes, which I've already shown you in my digital planner video. So GoodNotes is a paid app, as I mentioned in the previous video, for those of you that have already seen it. If you haven't, it is a paid app. I want to say it's like $7 or $8. I should probably look up the pricing if I'm going to keep recommending it in my video. But basically, Good Apps is a note-taking app and a planning app, which is right up my alley. That's exactly what I need. And when I tell you I can do almost everything in GoodNotes, I don't need any other planning or note-taking app.
So I've shown you guys GoodNotes already, but to quickly give you the rundown, if you click that plus sign, you can do like a quick note, a notebook, or just a basic note in there. Once you click notebook, because that's usually what I go to, you can select a page that they give you. Of course, there's a blank option, there's lined paper, different widths and lining, and then I've shown you the planner pages already, and then you also have like some of the basics which got cut off in my screen recording, but there's a bunch of different pages that you can choose from. And then for the covers, you can actually choose different covers for your notebooks as well. So they have a bunch of different options on there. I always switch the covers just so I can immediately see which notebook I'm going to without even having to look at the title. So I do switch up the cover from time to time, and then you can actually write on the cover as well if you go into the edit mode. But I'm just going to create a notebook so you guys can see all the features really quickly if you didn't see my digital planner creation video. First, I'm showing you how you can add additional pages because you can keep adding pages, and then we'll go into the pen. There's a couple different options here. You can change the width of the pen as well. So if you want a thinner pen, so like a fine font, you can do that. You can change the color, or we can go with a thicker font as well, and you have a more bold pen, more like a marker. And then you have the eraser, which you can change the size of the eraser as well to erase anything that you may have made a mistake on. And then you have the highlighter, which the highlighter, you can change colors as well, and you can also change the size of the highlighter also. Then you have the shapes. So once you click on shapes, it doesn't give you shapes you can select. You actually have to draw the shape, and then it'll snap it into place. So you can draw a square, rectangle, you can do circles, whatever shape you want to create, and then it'll snap it in place, or you know, like draw straight lines for you if you need to. Then you have the lasso, where you can select certain objects and move things around. I've also shown you guys the stickers that I can add in here, so I'll just throw one in there, and then you can also add pictures to your notes as well. And then you can also do text if you prefer to use text instead of using your own handwriting with the pen. You can type in here also. You can change the font, you can change font size, you can change the color, you can customize your text the way you need to. Then if you click those three dots in the top right corner, you can do all the changes, saving, add pages, whatever you need to. In the left corner where it has all those squares together, that shows you like the layout of your notebook, so you can organize pages how you need to. You can delete pages, add pages.
And then another app that I use frequently on my iPad, which I've shown you in the previous video as well, is Keynote, because that is where I actually create my digital planners there. Keynote you can also use, of course, to make presentations. That was the purpose of it, which I've done some presentations in there for Fashion Formula 101, but I use it mainly for digital planners.
And here's an example of a Keynote presentation. Of course, there's themes. They even allow you to add live video. You can collaborate with other people on a presentation or whatever you're working on. So I'm just gonna go in, show you guys what some of the themes look like. There's a few different options for a few different things, but they're pretty basic. If you really want good templates, you'll want to use Canva, but I'm just gonna select one so you guys can see some of the basic features. So you have the styling tool where you can change the layout of the page that you're working on, change the colors, background. This is where you would edit text. And then you have the plus sign where you can add in things. So you can add pictures, you can add in a bunch of shapes they give you. They have tables and charts. You can add in grids like I showed you guys in the digital planner video. So you have the different grid options. Then you go to the three dots. That's where you would save it. You can share it, export it, whatever you need to do with that document. The plus sign that's in the bottom left corner, that's where you can add additional slides.
And then another way I use my iPad a lot is for photo editing. And I use a few different apps that I'm gonna show you guys today. Of the apps I use is Snapseed, PixArt, Facetune, and Photo Room, which I've shown you Photo Room before. Then of course I have like Lightroom and Photoshop on there too, but I'm just gonna show you a few of the easier apps to use.
First is Snapseed. You guys might remember Snapseed from the video I did on how to blend a bunch of pictures together with that double exposure feature. That was Snapseed I used for that video. I'll link that in the description box so you can revisit that. Then we have PixArt. PixArt, you can do a lot of creative things with your pictures. So if you really want to edit and have fun with your photos, I highly recommend PixArt. So as you can see in this video, you can do a lot of text, background, they have stickers, graphics. PixArt, you can take out the background. Actually, PixArt is one of those apps that people use to like alter their bodies to make them look like they got a BBL but they really didn't. That is PixArt people are using on there. So just so you can see, it's an all-in-one editor. You can edit and design videos as well. You can recreate video or pictures. You can add stickers, you have collages, change out the backgrounds, and then there's a bunch of templates on there that you can use as well. This is just an all-around photo editor. Next we have Facetune, which you guys probably are already familiar with Facetune, because this is where people really go in and edit their faces. Basically, like, you can change the way your entire face looks. I mean, you can change the shape of your face and all. See how they're doing here? Completely change the shape of your face, your entire look. By the time you're done with Facetune, you can actually look like a completely different person. You can even add makeup. But I use Facetune for some of the filters they have on there. They have a golden one that I like a lot. So again, on Facetune, you can retouch, you can reshape, you can add backgrounds on there. The filters is what I use. And then they have like some other stickers and stuff that you can throw on your pictures as well. And then lastly, we have Photo Room, which I've shown this in a video before on a good app of how to remove the background from your images. I use Photo Room just for that. You know, they show you that you can create collages and you can add other backgrounds. But when I want an image with a transparent background, Photo Room is my go-to for that.
And if you guys thought you were going to watch this video and I don't show you Canva, you are crazy, because you know I use Canva for everything too. So Canva is a content creation app, I should say, because you can create almost anything in Canva, whether you're creating packaging for your business, whether you're creating social media content, you can do videos in Canva, presentations in Canva, you name it, Canva has it. Just type it in and it'll come up for you. If you don't see it when you type it in, scroll through a bunch of the design options they have. There's so much you can do in Canva. And then the iPad, just like the iPhone, comes with a bunch of apps that I tend to use on a regular basis, like reminders. I actually use those because I tend to forget a lot of stuff, especially with a lot going on. It's hard to remember everything, so I use reminders. Notes. I use Notes still sometimes, even though I use GoodNotes more than anything, because I had already been using the regular Notes apps before GoodNotes. I still use Notes sometimes. Of course, podcasts. You guys know I talk about podcasts often, so I definitely use podcasts. And then the calendar I still use. Now, as far as the other apps that I use for the apps that come with the iPad, I use Mail on there too, but I use mostly Mail on my phone. On the iPad, I tend to use Spark more. And Spark is another emailing app. But I don't know, for some reason, I just like Spark a little more. So let me just show you Spark.
So here is Spark, which is similar to the Mail app, but I can add a ton of different emails in here, and it's so much easier to organize all these different inboxes with Spark. I can also add signatures that have the pictures. They also have a calendar, which I haven't tried yet and I need to try. But you can also integrate Spark with a bunch of other apps, which makes, you know, automation easier when it comes to running a business. And you can also collaborate on your emails with Spark.
And then next we have Giphy. So for those of you that don't know what Giphy is, that is where you can find a bunch of different GIFs to use. I use it mainly for the stickers because I use those in my email campaigns and then on social media. And on Instagram, when you're uploading stories, you can get the GIFs from there, and they're actually coming from Giphy. But Instagram only shows you so many, whereas if you go search those same terms in the Giphy app, you'll find a whole bunch more. And then in that app, you can also create your own GIFs. So I like that a lot, so I can create my own stickers there. And then lastly is iFont. I use iFont because I like to use custom fonts. Now, in Canva, if I'm creating something in Canva, they have a ton of different fonts in there I can use, so I don't need fonts for that. But when I'm creating like my digital planners and then in GoodNotes, iFont comes in handy because I can use all those different fonts. There's a few other apps you can actually use iFont in, but I use iFont because I can go on websites like defont.com and download pretty much any font on the internet and use it on my iPad. So that keeps things creative and helps with branding when it comes to my business. So those are all the apps I'm gonna show in this video, just so it's not too long. There's a ton more that I do in my iPad. Even when I'm running errands, I tend to bring my iPad with me, so I don't go anywhere without it. I do everything on there. It is one of the best investments I've made. I highly recommend it if you don't have it, especially if you're running a business. Thank you for watching.